हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, डियर स्टूडेंट्स। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी टेक एंड रिवाइज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर एनसीईआरटी एक्सरसाइज। ओके, नाउ इन टुडे क्लास वी टेक एंड रिवाइज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर एनसीईआरटी एक्सरसाइज व्हिच इज व्हाट, लाइंस एंड एंगल्स। ओके Just in that chapter, we already discussed so many important concepts related to line and angles. We discussed about the adjacent angles. We also discussed about the linear pairs. What is the form? What is the condition of linear pairs? And also, we discussed about the condition for the vertically opposite angles. And we already discussed about the angles made by the transversal T. Okay, now, in today's class, first of all, we take and solve the question based on complementary and supplementary angles. Dear friend, what is the concept of complementary and supplementary angles? You know, already we discussed about in previous classes, dear friends, ki two angles are said to be complementary to each other if their sum of measures is what? 90 degree. And two angles are said to be supplementary to each other if their sum of measure is what? 180 degree. Now, in today's class, we take some important question based on that topic. Let's see. We take the first question. We take the question which is what? An angle is equal to. Is equal to one third of its supplement. An angle is equal to one third of its supplement. Okay, find its measure. Let's see its solution. Dear friends, here we find an angle which is equal to one third of its supplement. So, dear friend, first of all, we take the angle be X. Okay, let's see. First of all, angle be X. Okay, then its supplement will be what? 180 minus X. Because of here two triangles are supplement to each other, it means that their sum of measure is what? 180 degree. So this is the concept of supplementary angles. Okay, now first of all, we take the angle BX, after that its supplement will be what? 180 minus X. Now, according to statement, what is the condition of that question? According to this statement, dear friends, find an angle is equal to one third of its supplement. Means angle X is equal to one third, means 1/3 of its supplement. Means this what? 180 minus X. Okay. Because of the angle, we take the angle is X, then its supplement will be what? 180 minus X. And the angle is one third of its supplement, means 1/3 of 180 minus X. Now we simplifying them. Let's see. So we get what? 3x is equal to 180 minus x, that is 3x plus x is equal to 180, that is 4x is equal to 180. So the value of x is equal to 180 divided by 4. Thus the value of x is what? 180 divided by 4. So we'll divide it 180 by 4. So we get what? Let's see. 4 4 4 is 16 carry 2, so 4, 5 is 20. Thus, the required angle is what? 45 degrees. This is our required solution of the given question. Thus, dear student, in this way, you can solve all the question of your syllabus based on the supplement and complement angle in this way. Now, we take and solve some other important question based on that topic. Let's see. Now, let's see, let us take some other important question, okay?
Let's see.
And the question is, if the supplement of an angle, let's see, if the supplement of an angle, if the supplement of an angle is three times its complement.
Its complement,
find the angle. Find the angle. This is also a very important question of your syllabus. Let's see its solution. Dear friends, in that question, here if the supplement of an angle, according to that question, if the supplement of an angle is 3 times its complement, is what? 3 times its complement. Find the angle. So first of all, let the angle be x. Okay, distance, let the angle be x. Then its supplement
will be what? 180 minus x, and its complement is what? 90 minus x.
Then its supplement is what? 180 minus x, and its complement is what? 90 minus x. Okay, dear students, now according to question, if the supplement of an angle, and we take the supplement of that angle is what? 180 minus x, okay? Supplement of an angle is 3 times its complement.
Supplement means 180 minus x of an angle is what? 3 times its what?
Complement.
Means what? 90 minus x. Okay, it means that
supplement is equal to 3 times its complement.
Now, we solving this, then we get 180 minus x is equal to 30. This is 270 minus this is 3x. Now, let's see. This 3x transfer that side, so plus 3x and minus x right as it is equal to 270. That transfer that side is what? Minus 180. So, we get what? This is 2x is equal to, this is 0. 79, okay. Thus the value of x is what? Thus the value of x is what? 91 upon 2, that is 45 degrees. Thus the value of x is 45 degrees. Thus in this way, dear friend, we can say that the required
angle be what? 45 degrees.
This is your final answer. This is your fine.
Okay, thus dear students, in this way you can solve all the question of your NCERT exercise based on the topic complement and supplement of an angle. Now, dear students, we are going to take some important question based on linear pair. Based on linear pair, we already discussed about that topic in your previous classes. Now, we today's class we take some important question based on linear pair. Let's see. In the given figure, the question is, in the given figure, find the value of x. In the given figure, find the value of x. Let's see. And your figure is what? Let us take. We have two questions here. First part of this question is what? Let's see. This is line AB. A and B. And two rays stand on it. In this way. COC and OD. Okay. This is X plus 10. This is X. And this is what? X plus 20 degree. And second part of this question is what? This is PQ, array PQ, and array stand on it, and array stand on it, which is OR. This is 3x, and this is what? 2x plus 10. Now let's see. That's why in both the figures, just we find the value of x. That's why in previous class, we discussed about the concept of linear pairs. What is the concept of linear pairs? There are two adjacent angles are said to be linear pairs. If two or more than two adjacent, if it have, they have the common vertex and they have the common arm and their non-common arms are opposite rays, so they form a linear pair. And you know that the linear pairs of an angle are supplementary to each other. It means that their sum of measures is what? 180 degree. Now let's see. We take and solve the first part of this question. This one here. Some figure. AB is a straight line. Okay. AB is a straight line. Then that is all the angle on it is equal to the sum of all angles on it is what?
180 degree.
That is angle AOD, angle AOD plus angle COD plus angle BOC. Angle BOC is equal to what?
180 degree. Now
we put all the values in that equation. Let's see. The value of angle AOD is what? This is x plus 10. The angle COD is what? This is angle x. Plus angle BOC is what? This is x plus 20 is equal to 180. Now we simplify x plus x, that is 3x plus 10 or 20 is what, dear students? This is 30 here. Is equal to 180. Now the value of 3x is equal to 180 minus 30 degree. Now we get 3x is equal to 150. That is the value of x is equal to 150 divided by 3. 3 5 is 15. 0. Thus the value of x is what? 50 degree. Thus in this way, in first question, first part of this question, the value of x is what? Calculated by the help of the concept of the straight sum of the angle on a straight line is 180 is what? 50 degree. Okay, dear friend. So in this way, you can solve all the questions based on these topics in this way. Now we take and solve next part, second part of this question. Let's see. Now we take the second part of this question and solve it. Dear student, in second part of this question, let's see, from figure it is clear that angle POR, and angle QOR form a linear pair. Form a what? Linear pair. That is, if you know that, yes, in previous class we discussed about that. If angle POR and angle QOR form a linear pair, then their sum of measure is what? 180 degree. Okay, that is their sum of measure means what? That is angle POR plus angle QOR is equal to what? 180. Now from there we put the value of angle POR and angle QOR. We get, let's see, angle POR is what? 2x plus 10 and plus angle QOR is what? This is 3x is equal to 180. Now we simplify them. That is 3x and 2x is 5x is equal to 180 plus 10, transfer that side, minus 10. Thus 5x is equal to 180 minus 10. That is what? 170. So the value of x is what? 170 divided by 5. Let's see, 5 3 is a 15, carry 2, 20. 5 4 is a 20. Thus the value of x is what? 34. This is our required solution of the given question. Okay, dear student. Thus, in this way, dear student, you can solve all the questions of your syllabus based on linear pair in this way. Now, dear student, we are going to discuss and take some important question based on angle made by the transversal and solve it. Let's see. Now let us take some important question based on angle made by the transversal and simplify them. Okay. Now let's see. In the given figure, we take a question. In the given figure, okay, in the given figure, if L1 parallel to L2, if line L1 parallel to line L2, then find the value of y. Then find the value of y. And your question is, L2 line L1 and L2, which are parallel to each other, and a third line L3 cut as transversal, then that angle is equal to 3x, that angle is equal to y, that angle is equal to x. We find the value of y. Okay, different. Now let's see. Suppose that angle intersect that point at P and Q respectively. Okay, now let's see. Dear friends, first of all, here L1 parallel to L2, na?
Now we aim at that.
We find the value of y. Dear friends, let's see its solution. From figure, it is clear that L1 parallel to L2 and L3 as a what? Transversal. Then, let's see. Yes, and here if we take two lines L2 and L3, then they are intersect each other at point this. So the vertically and opposite angles are also equal to each other. So this is what? As 3x, because of alternate, this is the vertically opposite angles are equal to
each other. Now let's see. L1 are parallel to L2 and L3 is a transversal. Then
angle X and angle 3X
are the pair of consecutive interior angles. So, and we also know that the sum of angles, the sum of consecutive interior angle are supplementary. Okay.
Now, then from figure, the value of X and 3X is what?
180 degree.
Why? Because of the comma. This is consecutive interior angles.
Okay, now we simplify them.
X and 3X is what? 4X is equal to 180. Thus, the value of X is equal to 180 upon 4. That is 4 is 16. Thus, the value of X is what? 45. Now,
but dear students, what we find? Dear student, we find the value of y. Now again, let's see. L3 is a straight line and the sum of angles on the straight line is what? 180. Again from figure, now
again from figure, what? X plus y is equal to what, beta?
45 degree. X plus y is equal to 45 degree because of they form a linear pair. They form a what?
Linear pair. So let's see. Now we put the value of X as 45. Let's see. This is what? 180. Their sum of measure is 180, no? So 45 plus y is equal to 180.
Okay. Now from there we find the value of y.
What? Let's see. The value of y is what? 180 minus 45. We just subtracting them. Let's see. 10 minus 5, that is 5. 7 minus 4, that is 3. 135 degree. In this variation, the value of y
in that for that question is what? 135 degree. Okay, thus dear students, in this way you can solve all the question of your syllabus based on the topic and angle backed by the transversal in this way. Now we take and solve some other important question of your NCERT exercise. Okay, let's see of your syllabus. Now let's see. In the given figure, take a question.
In the given figure, L parallel to M.
L parallel to M, find the value of X.
Okay.
Find
the value of X
and we draw the figure.
This is L. This is M.
L parallel to M. Okay.
And cut by the transversal T. Cut by the transversal T.
And this is 2y plus
25.
2y plus 25. This is what? X plus 15.
X plus
15.
And this is 3y.
Okay. Dear friend, in that question, we find the value of X. Okay. Let's see.
Let's see the solution, dear friend.
Since lines
L parallel to M and cuts by a transversal T. Then cuts by the transversal T. Then let's see. This and this, the pair of angle 3y and 2y plus 25
is the alternate interior angle, and you know that alternate interior angle are equal to each other. Okay,
then 3y is equal to what? 2y plus 25, because of these are the what? Alternate interior angle. Alternate interior angle. Now from there we get what? This is 3y, 2y on that side, so minus 2y is equal to 25. That is what? 3y minus 2y, that is y is equal to what? 25. In this way, there's a, first of all we find the value of y. Okay, now again from figure, that angle is equal to that,
because of these are the vertically opposite angles, and you know that dear friend, the vertically opposite angles are equal to each other. Vertically opposite angles are what? Equal to each other.
It means that x plus 15 is equal to 2y plus 25. 2y plus 25. Okay. Now we put the value of y, okay, that is x plus 15 is equal to 2 into 25 plus 25, that is x plus 15 is equal to 25 to 2 the 50 plus 25, that is x plus 15 is equal to 50 plus 25 is what? 75. That is the value of x is what? 75 minus 15, that is x is equal to what, dear student?
60. X is equal to what?
0, this is 60. Thus in this way, dear student, the value of x is what? 60.
Okay, dear student, this is one of the most important question of your syllabus. Okay, so please do more and more practices of that type of question, because of this is a very important question. Okay, now let's see once more time. Dear students, here in that question, two lines L and M are parallel to each other, which is given in our question, and cuts by a transversal T. In that question, we find the value of x, and in that question, that angle is 3y, that angle is 2y plus 25, and that angle is what? X plus 15. Now, lines L parallel to M and cut by a transversal T, then these are vertically alternate interior angle, and we discuss about that direction. When two parallel lines cut by the transversal T, then in that condition, the pair of alternate interior angle are equal to each other. So first of all, from there we get 3y is equal to this, that is, after simplify then we get our value of y as 25. Okay dear students, now in this way we find the value of y by applying the concept of linear vertical alternate interior angle. Now again from figure, these are the vertically opposite angles, and you know that vertically opposite angles are equal to each other, so here we apply that concept. Okay, now in that expression, algebraic expression, we put the value of y and simplifying them. So in this way, after solving them, we get the value of x as 60. Thus, dear students, in today's class, we take and revise very important chapter, very important topic of your syllabus, which is line and angles. Now, dear students, first of all, you revise all the questions which we discuss in that class. After that, you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise. Now in next class we take some other important chapter, okay, and revise it. Now thanks to all.